This is Falstaff, and you are watching Brutally Delicious with Bruce Moore.
Hey, welcome to Brutally Delicious. I'm Bruce Moore. Today we've got a great show in store for you. We're going to be joined by Victory Records recording artist, The Bunny the Bear. And if you stay tuned, we're going to see what they have cooked up for us today. All right, so if you want to go ahead and follow us in, we'll see what they have cooked up for us today.
Hey guys, welcome.
How you doing, man?
Thanks for coming on, I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
What do you guys got cooked up for us today?
Here's some fried raviolis.
Who doesn't like fried ravioli? I mean, that's a great late night kind of thing, or even, I guess, probably even tour food, right?
I've never had them on tour, but yeah, really late night things I don't like that.
Oh,
I have munchies for them, I don't know how often he eats them, but.
A couple times a year.
Excellent. Well, if you're ready, we can go ahead and jump in. And while we're cooking, I'll go ahead and grill you with some questions, and we'll see where we end up.
Beautiful.
Perfect. All right, how do we start here?
Okay.
We got some breadcrumbs?
Yeah, we do. We have eggs and what is that, buttermilk or normal milk?
It's just regular milk.
Regular milk?
Yeah.
That's what I use, so that's perfectly fine. But we dipping them over here.
Okay. And while we're talking, we're going to talk about your album here.
Yeah.
Your new record, Stories, has just been released not too long ago. And now that it's complete, how do you feel about it? And are you satisfied with the outcome?
I love it. Actually, it's my favorite album so far.
Is it?
I'm usually not satisfied with albums after they're done, ever.
Right.
But we just break them in there?
Yes. Yeah, you can break them in there. That's fine.
You're the egg man, you know? You see me crack an egg in later life. But,
I hear a lot of people, you know, they, hey, I wish I would have done this, or hey, I wish you would have, in hindsight. Like, in hindsight, you happy with the way the album turned out?
I'm very happy with it. Extremely. I don't know. How do you feel about it?
I am very pleased with it. It's my favorite album that we've done so far.
Real quick. What's your writing process like? You guys all write together, or is it more the efforts of one person?
I pretty much write everything, at least for all the major albums I have.
I have a terrible whisker.
You know what I mean? Are you a good whisker?
I cannot do a whisker.
I'm going to show you guys how to cook this shit.
This is okay. Exactly how it works.
But no, I pretty much write the music, the songs, lyrics, stuff like that, melodies. We get together after pretty much an hour after stuff. We start working on some vocals and this and that, and bring it to life in the studio.
Okay.
I mean, even in the studio, I don't really bring anyone in. I mean, me and the producer pretty much for the last like 2 hours have recorded everything, and then he hops in my vocal days and brings the sexy.
Nice.
Yeah.
When you're writing though, are you writing with the live setting in mind, or how it's going to translate into the live setting, or are you writing a song just for the song?
I just write it. I don't think about how it's going to translate at all. That's why so many people probably think you're weird.
Right.
Maybe if I thought about that more, you know. No, I just naturally just write.
So then how does that work? Is it difficult? Do you find it difficult translating those songs into the live setting? Or is it just something
you've never... There's a few songs on albums that I want to play live, but they just don't translate live. They can't live at all. They're horrible. Horrible live. Some good songs, too. But most of them are just fine, you know. Most of them are way heavier live than people even expect. They listen to some of our CDs and some of it's like mellow, but live it's usually a lot more in your face.
A lot more aggressive.
A lot more, yeah. But as far as like translation, I don't really think about it much at all. It just kind of comes naturally.
Okay. What's the next step? Add some milk news that we're headed?
Yes, sir. I like you're like coaching us along.
No, that's good. Right. I got like about a half a cup of milk there. I don't know if you need more. We've got more.
I think this would probably be fine. I mean, maybe grab enough egg in there. What's that again?
We got more. I read the recipe you sent me.
I think
we're good. Am I back to whisking here?
I probably need to whisk it away.
I'll be the official whisker.
Thank you.
I know you've had a rough night. Are there any tracks on Stories that are personal favorites? Good stories behind? Stories.
Yeah, good stories behind. I mean, the title Stories is more just because generally there's so much different subject matter. But as for like anything really close to home and important, there's nothing that really is like my number one stick. I like all the songs. I mean, they all mean something to me just because I'm going to hear it and writing them and stuff. But I mean, as for favorite listening purpose wise, I like It's Not Always Cold in Buffalo a lot.
Okay.
I think it's a good track. I don't know what would you
see. My favorite song by far, Hey Alley.
Okay. What about live? Is there one that goes over better live? Or
I know we've played a few so far. Yeah, and they just came out. I mean, all we've really played at all live is like KLE and like Flynn, which is the premier single and is our single right now.
Right.
And we're coming out pretty soon. But ISR is really good live. Not too fond of KLE decently. It's heavy, but
right.
You know, still one of the songs where you just gotta get used to do it over and over. It's just like,
but the heavier songs probably go over well with the crowd, right? Gets them moving, bumping, and whatever.
Even the lighter songs, though, even like the Dancer, Hey Ali stuff, it's still kind of heavier live. I mean, cause just because of the tunings or guitars and stuff, we play pretty low.
Right.
And they're just so low in the mix, in the actual recording process, that you just don't understand how much there actually is there until you hear it live and it's actually crunchy, you know? But yeah, I mean, the heavier ones definitely go over well. It's better for like a, yeah, especially a lot of tours where you're on a band and play. For so many, like everyone's playing heavy music now. So,
right.
You know, it's hard to find a band that sounds like us. So when you have openers from local venues and local places, they're always all heavy crunch bands, you know what I mean? So,
right.
So playing the heavier song is definitely probably a smart choice.
Right. Well, I guess for the crowd, my next question was that, we'll put it on hold for 1 second. So is it weird playing with that kind of mixed genre, or does it end up working out in the end?
I don't like doing it. Not much at all.
But it would be hard to find somebody that, and like you said, that would be the same kind of music as you.
Yeah, you know, I agree. I would prefer playing with popular bands than us, and just being the heavier band.
More like a dubstep sort of thing?
Or not about anything, even just poppy rock. I don't really
and they just come out and be the ball for the
It throw people off, I think, more so than anything. I think it just depends. I mean, our music's very, a taste, you know what I mean?
Right.
So even for like kids who are into heavier stuff, even we play the heavier songs, sometimes they're like, shit, that's weird, I don't like these guys, you know what I mean?
Right.
But sometimes they love it. They're like, oh wow, I didn't like these guys when I heard their actual, you know, song, but when they come live, it's a little different feeling.
Okay. Yeah. Alright, so next up.
Do you want to just mix this in, or are we dipping it after? Is that what we're going to do?
I think we were.
Because usually I half-ass it at home, man. I don't even bring it all. You brought in all the sections.
I brought all the
Parmesan
and stuff. And what do you got there? It looks like you got some Parmesan cheese.
We have garlic, Parmesan cheese, seasoned salt. It
looks like a little bit of oregano, right?
Yes, sir.
And these are just regular old seasoned breadcrumbs.
Uh-huh. Great. Okay.
Get that ready for you.
Yeah, you don't go scared.
I'll jump in here with you. And as far as measurements, I know I was measuring that earlier. That's like about a teaspoon, tablespoon of stuff.
Yeah, I mean, I was
a little heavy on the Parmesan because I'm always a big heavy Parmesan guy, so.
Probably fine, just eyeing it up. Your preferred preference, so.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with some Parmesan.
Can you mix this a bit, Bradley?
Give that a good mix. And then this is pretty simple. We're just going to go ahead and bread them like you're breading anything else.
Yeah, set them aside. Dip those in, make sure it's fully covered. And you know, pop them around in the ground, and
while you're starting this, you guys are currently on the road, correct?
Yes, sir.
How's that going?
It's going really good so far. We're almost about 2 weeks out. Show's been good. Crowd reaction's been good. Fans have come out. It's been a really actually enjoyable month. Compared to the last few tours, maybe this has definitely been my favorite. But we're out with our friends in Deception of the Ghost, our Bullets and the Records.
Right.
So it's been going really good, though.
Cool, and you've still got about, another 2-3 weeks left?
Yeah. We have about, 3 weeks, give or take.
All right, this is going to be a good question for Chris. Do you guys find the physical demands of the tour hard to keep up with the physical demands of the tour?
No.
No?
I mean,
do you do anything special to keep up with it, or do you just kind of go out there and do it?
Just go out there and do it. At the end of the day, it's you know, for us to wind down.
Right.
It feels a lot worse than it is, but...
Okay.
You usually feel better right in the morning.
Yeah.
No, but I should probably actually keep it shaved more so I can keep it physical demands. It's only shitty with the sick, you know what I mean?
Right.
That's the worst.
And I mean, I guess we should say that we had this plan for a couple days ago and you came down with...
Yeah, tonsillitis. And actually, I still have a little...
Is it the old adage though? Does the show go... I mean, the show must go on?
We haven't canceled one. I was highly considering it just because, you know, about a year ago, almost a year now, right? Like 8 months. I came up with it too, and it was horrible. I had to get like a sinus needle shoved in my ass in the hospital. It was pretty rough. But and that was after playing 2 weeks with it. Like we're gonna keep going. I didn't even know I had it.
Right.
So my throat was like a ball switch to you. So
all right, cool. So we're looking like we're ready to bread it.
Yeah, we're good. We're perfect. Are we just? You want to try to move the plate over here so we're not dripping?
Yeah, we can do that. Like, and just for people at home, we're using store bought raviolis package. But I mean, if you were adventurous enough, you can go ahead and make these yourself and stuff them with anything you want. I mean, you can do raviolis or meat raviolis. These are just regular old cheese raviolis.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of meat ones at all.
Like they just remind me of too much of like cafeterias when I was back in kindergarten or middle school or something.
Yeah, or I feel like I'm getting them out of like a chef board.
Yeah,
or something.
Right.
How about that?
The raviolis or whatever.
But yeah, so we're just.
All right, my hands have been washed enough, so you wash your hands early, so we can just go ahead and jump in.
He's a wash man.
I wasn't hinting at you, Chris. Finally help you out.
We'll do it, man.
So here's one for you.
Uh-huh.
I know you guys have been, you guys have toured quite extensively.
Yeah.
Keeping in mind that this is a family show, are there any stories that stand out as being exceptionally strange or odd? You want to tell them that?
As for a family show oriented? Not really.
I mean, you can go PG-13 if you got a PG-13 one.
Like stories that are odd. I mean, there's probably some times where, you know, there's a little trouble here and there. But no, as for odd, weird things, nothing like that really happens on the road, actually. I think our tour life is actually day-to-day, aside from being at shows, you know, we're not.
Right.
A little more boring than you'd expect. I mean, from dudes who ride around in kids' plastic animal masks.
You know. All right, well, since you brought that up then, what is it you like to do when you're not on the road or touring or recording or...
I like to relax. I like to see my kid.
Okay.
And, I'm an Xbox dude. I sat my ass and play Xbox.
Are you? Big gamer. Do you take one with you when you're in the road?
No. We actually used to when we had a bigger vehicle. Until that thing died down, we used to have a very big flat screen in the vehicle and an Xbox, which was awesome. It's nice when you have long drives, like rocking someone some Call of Duty or Halo or something.
Right.
You know, it kind of kills time, but I think now we're down to just rocking tunes when we're driving and sleeping. So
there you go. All right. So now we've got our oil hook. Heated up to about 375
degrees.
Yes, and I have a thermometer here, but we've been watching pretty closely and did a little bit of a test. We're just going to drop this in, a couple at a time?
Yeah, I would just do a few at a time. I mean, I would flip them probably, you know, they don't even really need to be in there probably for like 2 minutes.
I'm imagining any longer than that, they're going to explode, right?
No, so yeah. I mean, depending on how hot it is and the breading, I mean, it might just be way quicker than that.
Okay.
I mean, but yeah, you just toss them in there. I think you hear that, it's going kind of hard.
Alright, so now we've got the flip.
Yep.
Golden brown on both sides. So I'm going to hold the plate for you. We can use a little bit of a paper towel to drain off the oil.
Yeah, you're definitely going to want that.
Ooh. It looks like you've only got one package. What are you guys planning on eating the rest of the afternoon?
Oh, I have no idea. good question.
I don't think there's going to be any left after I get into them.
Hopefully not pizza, because we eat way too much of that on the road.
Wish we had like a smell-o-vision or something. You can whiff of that at home.
These smell great.
They smell incredible.
Can you smell that, Chris?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
When you guys are out on the road, do you find yourself stopping in odd off-the-wall places to eat? Do you search out those kind of places, or do you end up...
I feel like we eat way too much fast food. I love it, like, once in a while, we'll go to like a diner or something.
Right.
But I think we... Go have way too much fast food.
Opportunity or time to go find a a cool little local restaurant kind of thing.
Some people in our band do. Like some of the live touring band always goes out. Like where's that place? Where is it? In St. Louis, I think. Where is it? Yeah. Zombie Burger. Where is that place? Iowa? Yeah, Des Moines, right? I think. Yeah.
Really?
But they love going to that place, and I want to actually try going there this time when we're over there. But supposedly that place is amazing.
Do you find certain states that have better food, or is it just you find something cool?
I don't ever find anything better in Buffalo's food.
Yeah.
It's funny, I think it's kind of what you get used to, what you grow up with. I mean, I'm originally from Long Island, and you can't find bagels or Italian food in there. Sorry to anybody who's watching, but you can't find it.
Like, wings?
Wings. I mean, the home of the Buffalo wing, right?
Yeah. Doesn't compare to Buffalo anywhere.
Pizza?
Anywhere.
Even Long Island strawberry in New York City, I can't stand the pizza there.
That's funny.
It's like, you know, like the flat, like here.
Yeah, because I get outside of Long Island and, you know, here I am in Richmond, but I can't wait to go back and get pizza.
Well, I'd rather have that pizza than have these other states, because their pizza's horrible.
And same thing like bagels and all that other stuff. You know, you get used to your bagels or whatever anywhere you are. Now, maybe it's water, I'm not sure what it is, but.
Yeah, there's the difference in food is ridiculous. Ridiculous. For going to Canada, you just want a good piece of bacon and end up with Canadian bacon, which I actually like in sandwiches, like here, but that's not what I want in the morning, you know what I mean? So.
No, you want the nice, fried, crispy.
But yeah, I miss food at home. I really do a lot when we're on the road. I feel like that's why we eat so much fast food. It's like, you know, we don't even know where to go to get something.
Right.
Decent, you know?
What do you guys have planned after this tour?
As of right now, we have management's looking into a few tours, but more tours. Nothing solid right now, like set in stone that's been announced or anything.
Right.
But we're gonna be on the road pretty much the year. So.
How do you guys do most of the states? Do you guys ever get out of the states?
Yeah, and we were in the UK with a funeral for a friend, Escape the Fate, you know, a little over a year ago. Go to Canada once in a while. Aside from that, we're looking into, you know, Russia and some other places right now. I mean, I like doing that way more, you know.
Oh, yeah.
We're always going around the States, we're everywhere, so.
Right.
But it's all totally different experiences over there.
And it's sort of the same route. I mean, you play like a lot of the same clubs year after year, correct?
Yeah, I mean, there's so many places that you can, you know, that kids go out to and each day. No, and everything's closed. There's clubs closing down everywhere with the economy and stuff, so there's very few options if you want a decent show in most cities, so.
But a lot of those, I mean, if they put together those packages, a lot of those tours overseas do pretty well.
No, yeah. I mean, the tour,
especially in Russia or somewhere, I mean, that's got to be kind of cool anyway, to be able to go over there, play your music, the people who are into it, and still see the city on your day off.
Yeah, that's why I like Europe and going to UK and stuff so much. It was awesome. It was really nice, actually.
And you had a decent response while you were over there?
It was really good, actually. I couldn't be more happy with it. It was great. So trying to get back over there as soon as remotely possible.
Right.
I know we have a lot of fans over there always posting on our page all the time. They're like, when are you coming back to the UK or Germany or this and that? It's like, hopefully soon.
Oh, you guys made it all the way over to Germany as well?
We were in Germany, Netherlands, yeah. We were England, London, Scotland, Germany, the Netherlands. We went through France, right? Just to drive somewhere.
Is there one place you could say you'd like to get to that you haven't been?
I want to go to Australia.
I want to go to Japan.
Japan?
Yeah.
Metal's metal and, you know, hard music and is big in those kind of places. And they get big crowd. They get a lot more support. Maybe it's because of the economy. I don't know.
Well, the music scene is just, they're way more supportive too.
Right.
Like, way more. People over there are so nice. Compared to, I mean, I'm not like putting down with like
American
music, but like promoters, everything, talent buyers, fans in general, and people, they still just go out to see the music, even if they haven't
heard of it. And you play shows that aren't like, you know, 300 people, you're playing bigger places, right?
Yeah, no, when we were over there with Escape the Fate and Funeral for a Friend, they were big shows, and we were playing like the Roundhouse in London and stuff like that.
Right.
So, and it was great, so. And academies, I mean, those are huge
right.
places, you know, and they were packed, you know, so it was an experience. It's not like here, we're only playing like a couple hundred kid, you know, club
right.
or something.
Absolutely.
It's a whole different experience, man. And just the production over there, from lights to sound, they really do not, you know, they spend every cent they can, you know, it's ridiculous, the difference.
But maybe that's why people come out, because it's a full, well-done package.
Oh, it is, yeah, no, it's... Like going to a show, like the bigger shows there, it's ridiculous.
Right. And they still do the package deals. I mean, you said you were just out there with like four or five other bands, so you still get, just like here, they're just playing the bigger places.
Yeah. Right. I mean, definitely. I mean, most shows like that, I don't think they're my locals or anything.
Right.
Like yours on most shows around here, you know, unless you have a full package. But yeah, I mean, there's definitely multiple bands. I mean, I guess unless they're that big, where you play like
right.
a 4-hour thing in front of thousands and thousands of people every night. Where you don't need, you know, multiple, you know, don't
sure.
want or need, you know, multiple acts. Yeah, it's about the same thing.
So here you are at my favorite part of the show, the eating, the reason why I do the whole thing. Thank you very much. These look fantastic. Let's see what we have here.
Actually, do look good.
We got a little marinara sauce. The bear's already... Pour his on. We're gonna go ahead and do a little dipping.
I'm a dipper, too.
I'm a dipper as well.
I don't know if I ever eat in my mask. We'll attempt it.
and give it a shot.
Carrot slide up nice and easy with it.
Mmm. Crispy, but those are pretty fantastic.
Wow. I'm down with this, yeah.
I'm totally down with this. I always thought they were a late night snack, but you probably eat these anytime.
Yeah, I actually take with it any other time I've ever made them either, so.
That's perfect. Well, perfect, man. I appreciate you guys coming out.
Yeah, I appreciate
Thank you for
it
the
too,
time.
Man.
Yeah. Good luck with the rest of the tour.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's awesome.